Thanks, Tom. Lots of American kids don't go to the dentist. And among low-income families, the percentage going without dental care is even higher. But Vermont's dentists are stepping forward to treat more of these kids. New at 6, News Channel 5's Stuart Ledbetter tells us why. He's in our Vermont newsroom tonight. Stu?
Well, George, this has been a year-long effort to recruit more dentists to serve this population, especially in underserved counties like Bennington, Windham, Rutland, and Franklin. Pediatric dentists say that kids can suffer lifelong consequences from cavities left untreated long enough. So it's serious.
The top right one's just beginning to decay.
Gavin Jacobs of Colchester is only 4, and yet he's already a regular in Dr. Chuck Bookwalter's chair.
I'll squirt someone you know. There you go. Open big, please.
Dr. Chuck is a pediatric dentist who wants all kids to get preventative care and education early on. He works with Vermont's Head Start program to ensure family income is no barrier.
We've been pretty successful getting dentists to sign up to take some more Head Start kids on, and so access isn't so much of a problem.
A year-long effort by Bookwalter and Dr. Spin Richardson to recruit more dentists to accept Medicaid patients is starting to pay off, especially in rural areas. Of Vermont's 1,550 kids enrolled in the Head Start program, 82% have now seen a dentist. Most were just fine, but 1 in 5 needed follow-up care. Some kids were even hospitalized because of infections, extensive tooth decay, requiring general anesthesia.
You know, untreated cavities are potentially can have devastating results.
Regular checkups, he says, can prevent all of that.
I would like to put some sealant material into those to cover them.
Gavin's mom is on board with the program.
Like that, a lot of it's covered, so you know that makes it hard to believe that somebody wouldn't want to take their kids to get their teeth taken care of.
See you later, alligator. I'd encourage all parents to look at their children's oral health as a very important aspect of their life, and if they watch their snacking patterns and help with hygiene, we'd really appreciate it as a dental profession.
Or just follow Gavin's example. A Pew Research study out last year found a lot of kids around the country are suffering for lack of dental care, a problem it said has gotten worse over the last decade. But this area appears to be finding some success in giving more kids access to a dentist, and that's a real head start. George?